There. Well, look, on a slightly different subject, as well as having lots of property investors watching the show, many are business owners too. So tell us a bit more about the Entrepreneurs Organisation and what it does for some people.
Okay. When I first started, you know, in our own business, we find it difficult, we struggle, it's a lonely journey, and a lot of people don't understand, even our own family may not understand this. So when I found EO, I found that EO was a safe place where I could learn and grow as an entrepreneur. And I get help learning tools, just how to just manage the business, how to manage the staff. But there's so much more other learning. It's very fulfilling in the sense of entrepreneurship is just not business. It's also about my family, my community, and even myself. And in EO, we call that EO 360. All right. So it has been very well-rounded, and I feel very fulfilled and very enriched by
because
this experience.
Especially, like, I came from an accounting background, mm-hmm. job for life, big company, and you've got all this support around you. You suddenly start your own business, and it's pretty tough. It's very lonely.
Yes.
Everything's against you, your IT, your sales, your marketing,
That's
your
right.
accounting, the whole thing. And so at least you get to share with like-minded people that are struggling through the same kind of issues as
right.
well.
Yeah, it's a group of peers. What I love about it is it's just a peer group of entrepreneurs. And we have 8,800 members out there in 122 chapters in 35 countries. And guess what? 160 billion US turnover, bigger than some economies, right? And we strive to help entrepreneurs, leading entrepreneurs, with encouraging economies through job creation. Basically, that's how we are changing the world.
And so how do a lot of these businesses learn from the other businesses in the group?
Oh, one of the best benefit is forum. And it's basically small groups in 8 or 10 entrepreneurs. And we get together once a month. And it's a very safe and trusting environment where we can share business and personal issues. And yeah.
That's good. And look, I'm on the Sydney board, so I get a bit of a view of Australia. You're on the global board, so
right.
you're seeing a hell of a lot of different things.
Yes.
What are some of the different things that you kind of pick up on?
Well, it is, EO is a volunteer led, you know, so it's peer serving other peers. And what I've seen is it's wonderful leaders leaving a significant mark in the organization, encouraging others to do likewise, encouraging others to build up not only their business, but their lives and their families. And that's very different and very unique. I considered it a global classroom of which learning is totally unusual, unique, and it's edifying, and it's encouraging, and it's building up. Right.
So, look, I've been part of EO for about 2 years, so if you're in business, it's definitely worth learning. Just as we give the tips on property investing, it's all about research, then certainly business as well. There's always someone else doing something slightly different, so even in a flat market, then you can still be making money. So in Australia, a lot of the organisations that you might know are things like Red Balloon Days, Roses Only, Peter Switzer, his son's in the group, Lance Lay, a guy on Peter's show, is one of the past presidents of EO as well, and he gives a lot of advice about accounting and investing in shares around the country. So certainly there's a lot of entrepreneurs out there, and you never know where they're part of. Now, after the break, the latest property numbers. You're watching Your Property Empire.